This is my first self-help video, so if I screw up, I'm sorry, but if you have medium to long, thick, curly hair, like I do, I have majorly nasty curly hair, this is just a self-help video if you want to straighten your hair or if you're finding that your straightener isn't really doing the trick, or if you just need some tips, I'm here to show you how. Like I said, this is my first video, so bear with me. Things you'll need: a brush, of course, a rat tail comb, which if you don't have one, they're really cheap at dollar stores, like Dollar General. Also, plastic ones work. This has a metal tip and it's actually really sharp, so hopefully I don't stab myself. But this is just to help with the straightening process, and also to part your hair in the way that I do it. I don't do it the way normal people do it. I don't use any products or anything. Also, duckbill clips. Again, if you don't have them, they're fairly cheap at dollar stores. And also, they do sell plastic ones. Plastic ones don't really work as well, but they do work. And also, you'll see in a minute how thick my hair is. And also, you'll need one or even two hair ties. I always get the ones without metal. I hate the ones with metal. They suck. And also, your straightener, of course, which is actually getting very hot. This is my first time ever using this straightener. I got it as a Christmas gift. Thank you to my cousin and his girlfriend. So this is my first time ever using this particular hair straightener, but it's supposed to work. It's a Revlon. I like it. But first thing you're going to want to do is you're going to want to brush out all the tangles, which I have a lot of tangles, and especially down near the bottom. I have a lot of tangles, and underneath, if you have curly hair, you know what I'm talking about. Bear with me, guys. If you're soft-headed, you might want to wash your hair. Use like a typical amount of conditioner, like the amount that you would use. I myself use a bunch of conditioner, and then normally what I would do if I had time, or if I wanted to, or if it wasn't cold, like it's freezing out and I've got dogs, so I can't normally wash my hair at this time of night without getting sick. Let me throw some music on for you guys. Fall Out Boy. They're new to you, so. Okay, so you're gonna wanna take your rat tail comb and you're gonna wanna part your hair like you normally would for like a half ponytail. That's a pretty good amount. And you're gonna kinda wanna pile your hair up on the top of your head. Kind of loud. Sorry about that. If I start singing and offend people, I apologize. I'm actually in a pretty good mood, so singing kind of helps. Okay. You're going to want to put it into a messy bun, like I did, and just kind of have your regular hair the ones that don't fit in your ponytail, towards the top of your head, that way it doesn't get mixed in with the other stuff. And as you can see, I have a pretty good amount of hair down on the bottom, which is where your duckbills and your rat tail comb come in, because you can take the long skinny end of your rat tail and kind of want to part it to where you don't have a big section on top, and then twist it. I always twist it. Put it up towards your ponytail and just clip it with the duckbill. Make sure you push it in, that way it stays. If this helps people and you would like to know how to do other hairstyles, as you can see, I have a pretty decent amount of hair. So if you guys want to know any other hairstyles, I can look them up and I can show you guys how to do those. Okay, so as you can see, I don't have a lot of hair from where I parted, which is what you want. You don't want really thick sections, because the thicker sections tend to poof out more. And if you have thick curly hair, or if you have curly hair, even if it's thin curly hair, you know what I'm talking about. Because normally with curly hair, when you try to straighten it, even without product, like, I hate products. Unless it's dry shampoo or hairspray at the end, which I don't have any hairspray, so I guess I'll just have to deal with it. But you want to kind of run your comb through the rest of your hair. And even these kinds of brushes work also, because those get in the middle, the bristles do. So that should help. And I actually still have a knot. See, it's good to brush your hair. But you want to take your straightener, and first, before you start straightening this huge entire chunk of hair, you kind of want to take your finger and pull down, so that way you only have like this much. That way it's not a whole bunch and it's not too much strain on your straightener. Hold on a second. Okay, I'm back. Sorry about that. But yeah, you want to just take a little piece. I wouldn't say piece, a little section of that bigger section. And as you can see, I still have a lot of hair back here that I will get to. But, and then you just want to kind of brush it out best you can. And you want to take your straightener, of course. And you want to start at the top, careful not to burn yourself or your ear. And you just want to slowly pull it down. If you don't get it straightened the first time, like I did, so that means this is a really good straightener. Like, I have, it's curly. So you just want to, if it doesn't straighten out the first time, kind of go over it a second time, see how that works. And if it doesn't work, even go over it a third time. So you have a pretty straightened piece, pretty much. I love bald up them, so yeah. Okay. And then you want to take your other piece, and also your other hair tie will come in handy later on. I'm not going to use it yet, but it will come in handy. Okay, you just want to kind of go over it three times. My hair is really matted. And then you just want to integrate it in with that first piece that you straightened. And you just want to kind of start at the base and pull down. Try to hold your straightener as straight as possible, because if you don't, it will curl at the end. And I hate my curly hair. Like, I'll show you. It's kind of curly still, so I'll go over it a couple more times. And then you just want to straighten whatever else is left on there. And then you want to take your rat tail comb, and you just want to brush through it, just make sure. But I have a pretty straightened piece now. Okay, and then you want to take your one duckbill. That's a duckbill clip. It's looks like a duck. Okay, and then you want to bring that down. And remember, guys, when you're doing this, try to do it in as small sections as physically possible. Like, that's actually the way my hair is normally if I don't straighten it. But you want to do the same thing like this. I can just bring it into two sections. And you want to start at the back on this one, because if you start at the front, you'll lose where you started at. So I'm just gonna run through that, and the end's still pretty wavy. Okay, and on the more curly parts, you kind of want to go slow over it, because the slower you go, the more heat gets to it, and the straighter it'll be. It's actually still pretty wavy. And this is good for, like, if you have a lot of time, like if you have a date and you have a lot of time and you actually have time to do this. Normally it takes me about 45 minutes to straighten all of my hair. I have a lot of hair. And this straightener is actually really nice. The old straightener I was using, and if you find it's curling at the bottom, all you have to do, if it's curling out, then you want to turn your straightener like this. If it's curling in like mine is, you want to turn your straightener like this. That way when it reaches that curl, it's all nice and straight. And then same thing. And my old straightener was nice. It went up to, I think, 450 degrees. So I fried my hair all the time. That's why a lot of conditioner was nice for me. And I have another pretty straight piece, which I love. I love my hair being straight, and I hate it curly. Mother could beg to differ, but and make sure that if you have a necklace, it doesn't get caught, like mine just did. Okay. Okay, and then when you get that section done, you want to bring the other section that you started with, you want to bring it forward, brush it out, well, comb it out actually, you don't want to brush it at this point. I will brush the top though when I get to that part. You just want to kind of integrate it in and straighten that with the rest of your hair. That way you have a nice section of straight hair. And then bring down your other piece. I'm actually gonna hook these to here. Leave it just good. If I offended anybody by saying that, I apologize. I'm kind of busty, so it actually helps. Okay, and I actually have a pretty big section. So what I'm gonna do is I'm gonna take my rat tail, which you can actually see the difference between straight and curly. And I'm gonna take my comb, rat tail. Actually, the saw is not, so I'm gonna take my brush, handy dandy brush, and straighten that out a little bit. Okay, then you wanna take your rat tail comb, sorry, and you wanna put that into a section. And then whatever you have, twist and clip. Twisting and clipping is necessary because of the fact that if I wasn't putting this piece up into the other hair with the duckbill, I'd have this huge section and I wouldn't know how to work with it. So again, you're gonna wanna take that, put it into two sections. Two sections. And you wanna start at the back again. And you wanna straighten the back piece. Okay, and that's actually really straight. So I'm gonna put that towards the back of my head. Like that way it's laying down across my neck. Well, across my back actually. And then I'm gonna take my comb again, straighten this. Combing is very important also, especially, like I said, if you don't use product. The reason I hate much is because when you're straightening your hair, it tends to get greasy, or if you're one of the people like I used to do this is where the other hair tie comes in, because I'm gonna take this little section and I'm just gonna put it in a very loose, you gotta make sure it's loose, a very, very loose ponytail back here. That way it's back there, you don't have to worry about it, nothing like that. Then I'm going to take this other piece down. Okay, and then brush that a little bit. Again, three sections. And like I said, I'm new at this, so bear with me. Then you take your straightener, and you gotta remember to go very slow. This is not the kind of thing I would suggest if you're in a hurry, or if you don't have time for it, because this is actually really time consuming, because I'm already up to 19 minutes. So, and you gotta remember to start at the base of your hair, because that's the most poofy. I figured out, at least with my hair, it's most poofy because of the fact that I've got kinky curly hair, which is not nice actually. I hate it. So
So remember, go really slow with it. Throw that back, or put it in the back, actually. Don't really throw it. Throwing it puts air into it, which means that you'll get poopy hair again. And that's not very nice, especially if you're taking all of this time to straighten your hair. I have two little Chihuahua mixes in here with me. They're looking at me like I'm nuts. Okay. Cut that in back. And then you got this nice little itty bitty section that you still have to straighten. Which that is actually natural curls, which I was blessed with. I think it's a curse actually. And then you just want to straighten. Make sure you don't burn your ear. I've done that before and it hurts really bad. And you also have brown spots from the burns. So make sure you don't burn anything because it hurts so bad. I used to go to work and have burnt fingertips and wasn't nice. And again, if I start singing and offend anybody, I apologize. Okay, and see, that was so loose, I just pulled lightly. I pulled really slow, and it just came out. And then you're going to want to take your rat tail comb, and you're going to want to kind of comb through what you've already straightened. That way it stays straightened. Okay, and then now that I have this first section that I brought down straightened, what I'm going to do is I'm going to pull my hair out of here. Okay, and as you can see, I still have a bunch of hair. So what I would do is I would take it like my part that I started with. Parts right here, so I would bring it a little bit above that, and I'm actually using my fingers to do this, and again on this side, because my part is right here, so I'm going to just bring it up a little bit into like a V kind of pattern in the back, and then put all of that into another messy bun. I call it a messy bun, yeah. Because when you get done with it, it kind of looks like a bun. Okay, and see, you can see it. I have a V shape with the part. And then I'm gonna take my rat tail comb and I'm gonna part it in the back in the middle. That way I kind of have pigtails, not really. And then what I'm going to do is I'm going to take either this brush, which is a round brush, or this brush, which is a straight brush. And I'm just going to kind of brush through. That way you can check and see if you have any knots. Try not to use, if you are using product, try not to use a lot of it, because when you finally get done straightening it, it might feel greasy. My hair actually looks greasy. not shiny, greasy, whenever I get done. So I'm taking my duckbill comb, or my rat tail comb, sorry, and I'm going from the back forward, which, I don't do that right. Okay, you can actually kind of see it. Which my other hair is actually getting in the way now. Okay, that's better. Okay, and then, like I said before, twist it, and then bring it up. Okay, and that's kind of going to hang in your face a little bit, but I've got this nice little section here, which I'm going to straighten next, after I get this into a clip. No, not yet. Okay. And again, go from the back forward. And if you have a sharp rat tail comb like I do, try not to hold it next to your scalp because it might scratch you, and that's never nice, especially when you're applying heat to your scalp like I am now. Bring that up, grab your duckbill, and then you should have two duckbills up here. If you need more, go for it. I'm all for duckbills. I was in cosmetology. I love them. They are amazing. I've actually used them for body pins and actual hairdos before. I'm just getting caught on my cartilage ring. And then you're going to want to take smaller sections, which actually I should be using this little clampy, instead of the duckbills, but I'm addicted to duckbills. Okay. And you're gonna wanna take it in a little section. Try not to get the sections too big because it will poop out. Because if you're not paying attention, you might miss something. I'm actually using the clip. Okay, and the duckbills are also nice because once you take them out, you don't have to worry about it. You can just take it out and the hair will fall. But you're going to want to take a little section, which this section is actually very kinky today. And you're going to want to take it and go, I go medium, slow. But and also, if you use products, I've found out that it sometimes will make your hair burn. Horrible thing to say, but that's the reason that I don't use products. I hate it. Makes your hair greasy and slimy. And this is actually really nice because it's a brand new straightener. I actually just opened the package tonight. But pretty good straightener because it's actually straightening my hair. It doesn't have a temperature reading or anything on it. But it's actually working quite well. If not better than my old one. But if you can see, I still have a little bit of a curl. So I'm going to take care of that now. And I'm just gonna kind of twirl, like not really, so this is straight, and then I'm just twirling it a little bit, like maybe a quarter inch of a turn, or a quarter of a turn. And you just want to do that with all of the strands. And then it should just naturally fall out like it just did. And that part is straight. And you're going to want to put that to the back of your hair. But make sure this is out of your way. Like if you can, just pull it to the front of your shoulders. Take that out of the clip. I have more hair than I thought, which is not good. Okay. And then take your brush and brush it out a little bit. Like I said, put that in the clamp, and then you got a little section here. Take your rat tail, comb it out a little bit. Percy, what are you doing? It's my little Chewini Percy. He's adorable. I can't resist him. He's an adorable little guy. I love him. He's got little feet. You heard Fallout Boy? That's why he's in here. He's funny. He's my mom's puppy. Total mama's boy. But they aren't home right now, so he's kind of mine for a little bit. So you're just gonna wanna straighten that. Like I said, start at the base of your hair because that's the curliest part for me. Curly hair is a sickness and a curse. Careful not to burn your fingertips because, like I said, it does hurt. And now I'm just integrating that little chunk that I just straightened into the back ponytail, which I'll actually show you guys how loose I get it. And you don't want to pull it or anything. I'm just twisting it 3 times, which is normal because I can just pull it. Okay, and I'll even show you guys my little setup. We actually don't have an outlet in here. The outlet's in the other room. So I have to kind of set it up to where the straightener will reach, but not all the way to the cabinet or the vanity. And I just have my nice little setup like that. That way everything's grabbable. I almost said grabby. But everything's grabbable. You don't really have to worry too awful much about, like, if I can, oh my god, I can't reach this, or, where do I put my straightener and my other stuff that I need, that way it's right by you, like, it's right next to me, like, I can actually pick everything up. Thank you. and I'm just coming that little bit out. And I'm gonna take my straightener, start at the base, and just slowly work my way down to the end of my hair. And I actually have a pretty good amount of hair in this. Like, it covers all the way from the start, where the irons start coming together, and they're actually attached to the straightener, all the way to the end here. But it's still getting it moderately straight. I like how straight it's actually getting it, because I don't have to worry about it. That way, I have this nice little straight piece right here. The end's actually still pretty curly. Like I said, curse, not a gift. See how straight that gets? And I'm not taking big, huge sections either. It might look like I am, like with the amount of hair I have right here, but I'm actually not. What I'm doing is I'm sectioning off what I know that I can handle. And then you're going to want to kind of brush that out a little tiny bit. Careful not to grab the rest of your hair that's up here with it, because if you do, then you have a huge mess. And then as you go, your ponytail, you'll find out that you're not able to make it as loose as you want it. But I'm still getting it actually pretty loose. It's actually not taking as long as I originally thought, because I'm only at 38 minutes of it. Well, 37 technically. Now 38. So you're going to want to start at the root and work your way down. I actually don't really like this song, but it is Fall Out Boy, so they could have gotten a different person to do it, but I'm not one to judge. Fall Out Boy's awesome. Patrick Stump is hot. I'm in love with him. She's married, but I'm gonna steal him from her. Pipe dream. Everyone needs one, right? Anybody who can sing and play guitar as well as him and have amazing green eyes has my heart. Blue-eyed boys are suckers, though. I'm a sucker for blue eyes. Okay. And then take your comb, brush through, or comb through. And the back is actually pretty tricky. I'll show you guys how I do my back, the back of my hair. It's unorthodox from other people. Like I said, make sure you don't burn your ears, because I just did. And it does not feel pretty. The reason you want your hair down here in a loose ponytail is because if you were to put it into a tight ponytail, you would get it creased. And then everybody would be like, oh my god, you have amazing straight hair. But what's up with the crease? Like, you know, why do you have the crease in there? And then you're thinking, oh shit, you know, I didn't mean to, but shit happens. That's my favorite thing, actually, shit happens.
Okay.
And now that I'm done with this little section, what I'm going to do is I'm going to take my brush and I'm going to kind of try to brush it out a little tiny bit. Just make sure that you get all the knots and you got pretty straight hair. And again, loose ponytail. Woo, Elton John. I have pride for that man. He's amazing. He has an amazing voice. And he's gay, so he wins my vote. Okay, and then, and if you find out that your top ponytail is starting to get in the way or just really bad looking, I know, weird, but you can always redo it. That's why I love the no metal bands, because the metal actually hooks to your hair and it metal hooks to your hair, and that way when you go to pull it out, it pulls your hair, and I hate that. And then you're going to take your brush, brush it out a little bit, and since you have twisties, you'll find out that your hair will actually still be a little bit twisted. So you're going to want to kind of brush both parts out, that way they're not really that bad. And as you can see, I don't have big sections. It's not really all that big. And that way it's to the point where I can pull it. And it's nice because I got this parted in the right place where I still have both of my dust clips. So, off note, what do you guys think of the new album and the way that they're introducing the videos? Like, I saw all of them getting pummeled and I almost cried. Especially when they cut Patrick's hand off, get the briefcase full of whatever it was that was inside of the briefcase that obviously Courtney Love is going to be introduced in the next video. So I'm kind of hoping she plays a badass and gets her ass kicked by Elton John. Like I said, I don't judge though. I think Pink would have been a far better person for that part, only because Pink is obviously more badass than Courtney Love. And Tommy Lee looks like shit now. You can tell he's on drugs. Sorry if anybody is offended by that comment, but it's the truth. And I have a pretty good little section of straightened hair, which is actually, and my hair at the end will curl under. Curly hair does that. Okay. Alright, and then comb through. And the another awesome video, if you guys haven't seen it yet, look up Imagine Dragons Radioactive. That's another awesome one. It's got Lou Diamond. And if you haven't seen it, or if you have seen it, the first Percy Jackson movie, the girl that plays Athena's daughter, that is Percy Jackson's love interest. Well, my love interest. It has her in it. So, it's pretty good. I liked it. My sister and brother-in-law showed it to me. And I'm actually going to go back. Okay, different pace. Sorry. Okay, and then I have my section, and I'm going to comb that out, and then start at the base. Work your way to the root on one moment. Alright, sorry about that. We have a bird, and she was screeching. Even though I have a movie on for her and the dog, all of the dogs are watching it. It's called Money Pit. I watched it last night. Funny movie. Okay, and then I've got a pretty good straight piece. So I'm going to bring this section to the front. Pull this back part out of the ponytail. And then just loose pony again. And then the bottom's kind of getting poofy. So what I'm going to do is I'm just going to brush it. That way it's not as poofy anymore. Okay, Duckbill. Another reason why I don't use products is because it tastes nasty. It's a weird thing to say, I know, but with me, I use my mouth to grab the end of the duckbill, and that taste just lingers in your mouth forever. Isn't really getting straight. Okay, and I guess I have too big of a section, so I'm just gonna cut that in half. Again, duckbill in mouth. And if you guys are just wondering, I have a lot of hair, like I said, but also, just let me know what you guys think in the comments, or if you want to send me a message, feel free about it. I'm always on the internet, either on my phone or on my laptop, so let me know what you guys think, if I can help you guys in any way, or if this wasn't really any help for you, and I can think of any other way to help you guys, I will try my hardest. Now, that's really straight, actually, my hair anyway, and then I'm going to take that other piece down. I actually don't know what all I have music-wise on this phone. Another straight piece. And then bring this piece down. Goes back up. Duck bill. And if you guys need makeup tutorials, I can figure out how to do makeup, and I can also show you guys those. Thanks to my mom, I actually just figured out how to do my makeup more natural looking. So my eyes pop. I've got shit brown eyes. I hate them, but they make them pop really big. So I can show you guys that with regular makeup, not even totally expensive makeup. Bigger ponytail holder, or if you're using the same size, I'm actually going to take my smaller one, which is the second one down on my wrist, and I'm going to secure it with that before I even bring another section down, because I don't want to get it mixed in with the hair that I've already straightened. And because As you can see, this ponytail is actually getting bigger. So it's kind of useful to have two size ponytail holders. Okay, and then I'm going to take my brush. And then I'm just going to brush the tail down. I call it a tail. The downward ponytail, bottom ponytail, whatever you want to call it. Straighten that out a little bit, that way it's still straight, not really poofy. And then what I'm going to do with this, I'm going to take it out of here. And then what I'm going to do is I'm going to take my rat tail comb. And I'm just going to take a little section. My part's right here, GPC, obviously. I don't want to go too far over, just right there. And I just want to go straight back. Doesn't have to be fancy, just straight back. That way, got a nice straight line. As you can see, straight line. And I don't want to do this. I don't want to do this part yet. So I'm just gonna put that in a cute little side ponytail kind of thing. Okay. My little cheerleader side ponytail. And then I want to take this. I want to take my brush and just brush it out. And if you have short bangs, like I have short bangs, you'll see that come out. Like you can see mine right here. That's part of my bangs. I don't want to straighten that just yet. I want to straighten that with the rest of my bangs. So I'm just going to take that, section that off. That way I have a little itty bitty section. And then I do want to take my piece of bang. And I want to bring it over. Take my duckbill, clasp it in there. Make sure you guys put there. That way it's secure and you know it. And then you want to take your brush again. I have a lot of ringtones on here, obviously. I need to get better music. I'm actually shedding. And if you find that the tip of your hair is still coming up like curls, like mine is a little bit, all you have to do is just bring that down a little tiny bit. and stop at where the curl first starts, and then just hold it there for just a second, so we have a nice straight piece. And you don't have to worry about, oh, well, you know, my hair's still curled at the bottom, what the heck do I do? And then, as you can see, into my last little piece. And depending on where you part your hair, like I part my hair to the side, you'll have to kind of use it that way and just use that to your advantage. If you part your hair in the middle, it's actually easier. I haven't had my hair parted in the middle since, I think, 9th grade. And that was a long time ago, so... And nice straight little piece. Okay. And then I'm going to bring all that I just straightened to the front. And I'm just going to run through with my comb. Make sure it's actually straight. And it's not still a curly piece of mess. I actually don't know what this song is. Then loose ponytail. Again, you don't want to get it too awful tight because of the fact that, you know, if it's too tight, you'll get a crease. And then, again, guys. Sorry. Again, small section. Then I have another little section. And this section is the most important. That's where you determine where you want your hair to lay. And also, part of the back is in that too. I actually don't straighten the back until I get to it, which is actually right here. So I actually straighten this like regular, and I'll just put it where I want it. And actually, it'll be the first step that I straighten will be the back, which is actually this part, because it actually goes back here. And then you want to bring this up. Okay, you got this section right here. I'm actually looking in the mirror also, because I can't really see all that good. I'm actually curling my wrist as I straighten hair. Okay. As you can see, that part is actually really straight, and I'm shedding again. Except for the tip, so I'm going to take care of that now. And the trick I showed you guys earlier was I'm going to hold my straightener at the tip for just a few minutes, and I'm also going to curl it a little tiny bit, like you would curl with a straightener. And that's there. Okay. And just that's part of the back. This next section up here that I just parted off and I put in a little ponytail is actually the next part, has the next part of the back of my hair. So when it's done, it'll lay the way that I want it to. Rat tail. Okay. Now, as I'm doing this, I'm actually holding my hair at the base. That way, I have a really good hold of it. That way, it doesn't just sit there. And without product, you'll notice that your hair is actually a lot smoother than if you were to have used product in there. And more bangs. And that's actually holding the rest of my bangs also. The reason why is because my bangs have actually gotten longer, but they're still kind of short, so it holds them in place and also holds the rest of my hair. And start at the base. If I'm repetitive, I'm sorry. I'm actually gonna. Okay, you can see that's actually really straight. Then I'm gonna bring my last little bit down. I'm actually not gonna straighten my bangs just yet, so I'm just gonna leave those out. And I'm gonna straighten this because the way my bangs lay, depending on the way you cut your bangs, a lot of people do it differently. I cut mine at a diagonal, so they actually fall like this across my face. So the way that I do it, it's really important that I just wait for my bangs until the last minute. And that's the next section. Okay. and I'm just going to put the ponytail over to the other side. That's another reason why you want to have your ponytails nice and loose, so that way you can actually move the ponytail where you want it. And I actually want it over on this side, so I'm going to move it that way. And I actually have a little spot where it got tangled. So I'm just going to brush that out. As you're going, if you notice tangles, it's important to stop and just brush those out really quick, because if not, then that can mess up your entire, all of your hair. Okay, that's still really loose. Okay, and then I'm just going to bring this down. Then I'm just going to bring this to where I part it, which is about right here, and I'm going to go straight back. It's important that your lines are straight, because that can totally mess you up in the way, and I'm actually going to straighten this piece over here first. So I'm just going to put this into a little ponytail, that way when I'm brushing the other part out, I don't have a bunch of hair like getting caught up, getting caught up in this, which actually has a lot of knots. It's important to brush your hair out as you take it out of the sections, because especially when you get to the top, because the ponytail actually has, when you, I don't even know how to explain it, but, okay, and like I was saying, this is part of the back. It'll lay like this, so I'm just going to twist this. That's another reason to make sure you brush your hair out as you take it out of the section. Because if you don't, then your twist is still going to be there, and your hair still might be curly. And the main reason why I'm bringing it to the front is to get most of the curl out first, and then I'm going to bring it up, and I'm going to take my comb and do that, and then I'm going to take my straightener, which I have to stand back for this, and actually straighten it up, that way one, I can see it, and two, I'm not screwing myself up. And then when I get done straightening it, I don't straighten it up anymore. I always just, I'll turn like this, that way you can see it. I'll turn my straightener, and I'll do that. That way it's where I want it to fall. That's really important if you're straightening your hair. You always want to straighten it the way you want it to fall. I'm actually going to put my bangs back now, which you can see my bangs are short, but they're kind of long now. So I'm just going to put that over here, and I'm going to clip all of my bangs back. That way I can still see, and also that way they don't get mixed up in all the rest of the hair. Or in my case, the mess. Okay, and I have a nice little section. And I just bring this up and over. Duck bill. This is more like a movie, now that I'm looking at it. like I said, you want to straighten it to where you want it to lay. Like, I want this piece to lay right here. So I'm making sure that I straighten it and I'm pulling it down. That way it goes down and not out. You can do it various ways. I always found that way was the best way in order to do it. And since this piece is going to be the main front piece and it's going to lay pretty much right there, make sure you don't burn your eye. I'm really cautious about that. Make sure. So I'm kind of holding it away from my eye. And also I'm just pulling down. Like, just like that. And also, you want to take the hair that you just straightened, not the very front part, which I got some of my bang in there. You want to take your straightener and just go over it again to make sure that it's where you want it to lay. Like, this is perfect. So I'm going to take my bottom ponytail. And in a minute, I will take it all out of the ponytail and show you guys. But a good rule of thumb is if you're the kind of person that likes your ponytails to be kind of tight, you don't want that. You want it to where you can easily just pull, like that's using no force, and your hair will fall out of the ponytail. And this piece actually is all the back piece. Bit. So therefore, what I'm going to do is I'm going to take one of my duck bills and I'm going to part it sideways to where I still have a piece in the back where it's parted like that. And I'm going to take my duck bill and I'm not even going to tack it to the rest of my hair. I'm just going to bring it up. Actually, I probably should. Okay, and then we got this nice little piece. Make sure you don't drop your straightener. Like I said, I'm straightening it to the side right now, that way I get most of the curl, which I got most of the curl out. And then I'm going to bring it back, and I'm just going to straighten it the way I want it to fall. Another thing you'll notice if you ever go to get your hair cut, the cosmetologist or the barber will cut your hair the way that it's supposed to fall. One good thing I learned from cosmetology, there was a man there from London that actually worked with Fidel Sassoon. If you don't know who that is, then I'm sorry. Fidel Sassoon is a very, very big salon company. They actually now sell hair color in the dollar stores or Walmart. And so you can actually go and get the hair color that you want and it's permanent hair color. But the way he cut hair was he didn't use his hands like regular cosmetologists would do. Like, you ever notice the way that a cosmetologist or a barber cuts hair? They always have it really taunt and then they'll use their scissors and they'll cut. he actually doesn't use his hands. He uses two combs and a pair of scissors. And he says the reason why is because when you pull the hair, you're actually putting tension on the hair, so the length that your customer would want wouldn't be the right length, and then you would ultimately get in trouble or suffer the consequences. But the way he did it was the way he wanted the woman's hair or the bangs to lay, or the way he wanted to the way you would want the bangs to lay, or the, I want to say thin, texturized actually is the right word I'm thinking of. The way you would want the bangs to be texturized, he would actually take the, he would actually take the feathering implement, and he would use his fingers and actually hold the texturizer like this, and he would take the bangs and he would actually move the way he wanted the bangs to lay, which is what I'm pretty much doing right now with the back of my hair, because I want it to lay a certain way. So I straighten it the way I want it to lay, and it lays the right way. My hair is poofy, but normally when it's curly, it looks bad. Like I said, first I'm going to get all the curl, or most of it that I can, which the bottom is still curly, so I'm just gonna lay that. I don't want to put too much pressure on that, so I'm just gonna lay that there for now. And that way it's actually straight. And then I'm gonna take it to the back. And I'm going to lay it the way I want it to lay. And that's all of my hair except for my bangs, actually. So I'm just gonna put that into a ponytail, loose ponytail, and that's all the loose you want it, to where you can still move it with your hand, actually like fairly easy, like I'm barely touching. And then I'm gonna take my bangs out. This is the most important piece, because this is the piece that everybody sees, actually, and my bangs are everywhere, obviously. Alright, and here's the big kicker, because this is the easiest part to burn, is your forehead, and it actually really, really hurts, and you look like a dork with burn marks, and you have to explain to everybody I burnt myself. Okay, so I got those brushed out or combed out, and I parted it right where my part is, which is actually right here. Can't really see it right now because it's in a ponytail, but my part actually starts right here. I make sure that it's parted there because of the way that my bangs are cut. Alright, and then you're going to want to take your straightener, and depending on the way you want the volume to lay, hold on a second guys, I'll move you guys closer to me. Mm-hmm. now you guys are on the table. But that way you guys can see what I'm doing, and that way you can say, oh, she didn't say that. You can't say she didn't say that, or she didn't show me that, or anything like that. And my bangs are cut at an angle, as you can see. And actually, when I straighten my hair, it's all going to fan out. So I'm going to take my straightener, start at the base. Make sure you don't burn yourself, like I just did. And then I'm just going to pull it. And what I'm doing is I'm starting at the middle of my hair with all of my hair. And then as it starts to get longer, I'm actually pulling it to the side. I'll show you guys. My bangs are actually curly too, which has never happened to me before. Okay, I'm starting at the middle of my hair, and I'm starting to go that way, which is what Philip Wilson did with his, with the way he was texturizing the girl's hair. He actually took his and now you can see I have nice bangs. And then for this little little guy, just kind of want to run through it once or twice, even sometimes three times. And depending on how much volume you want, you can always start up here and then curl it like that, which actually curls up here, which is nice if you want a flirty kind of fun bang style. Okay, now all that's done. Okay, finished product. And then if you see any like little pieces like down here, it's kind of curly, or you know, you can just grab it and just run through it really quick with your straightener. Okay, and then you want to take your flat brush, not your round brush. Your round brush adds volume. I don't need any volume. If you want volume, you can use it. Depending on what you want, but I'm not going to use this. I'm going to use this instead. Kind of brush through my hair. Make sure that there's no stray areas that I might have missed or any knots. Okay, and I'm going to want to, you're going to want to turn your straightener off. That way it can start cooling down a little bit since we have reached the end, sadly. Okay. And if you want something fun, you can take the very front of your hair that everybody sees and just kind of run through it really quick. And then also another thing that you would want to do is if you want to curl it, that way it kind of curls in and it kind of feathers. I haven't had feathered hair in a while. Okay, and you want to take your comb and just kind of go through the top of your hair a little bit. Okay. Alright, and that's the end. Sorry it took so long. Now an hour and a half in. Like I said, first ever tutorial video, so kind of nervous. So just give me your feedback. Let me know what you think. Like I said, if you want to know some other hairstyles, I can find out how to do them and I can show you. Or, you know, makeup. I'm all for it. I can even do nails. So, alright. I hope that helps. I don't know what else to say. Everybody have a good night, or a good day, or a good morning, whatever time you're watching this at. I hope this helped you. If not, leave a comment. Tell me where I can improve. Alright. Thanks, guys. See you.